Hello everyone and welcome to oneAPI Dev News for July 2023. I'm your host, Jerry McCarr from IDZ Studios. Before we get going, I'd like to point out that all of the topics that we cover have additional information available that you can get by following the links in the description. The first thing I'd like to share is our Cuda to SYCL catalog. Visit the page and bookmark it to keep up to date with the latest SYCL code porting tools, training, and techniques that will unlock your code from the constraints of vendor lock-in. The page has direct links to GitHub repos, videos, articles, papers, and to the training and resource portal. While you are on the page, look at the oneAPI training calendar, see what on-demand training is available, and sign up to get updates. This catalog is a phenomenal collection of resources for developers. Next up, I'd like to share the awesome oneAPI GitHub repo. This repo is a curated list of awesome oneAPI and SYCL projects for solutions across industry and community. The table of contents contains AI-focused projects with computer vision, data science, machine learning, natural language processing, and frameworks and toolkits. Also included in the projects are data visualization, rendering, energy, gaming, manufacturing, mathematics and science, tools and developers, and a link to tutorials and training. Check out this repo to see all of the awesome oneAPI projects shared. Our final topic for this episode is the tech article oneDPL empowers your C++ application for cross-device parallel programming with SYCL. This article examines how the concept of heterogeneous computing puts a lot more horsepower at the fingertips of present-day developers by distributing various workloads to multiple varied computing cores, such as CPUs, GPUs, and FPGAs. The article also digs into the SYCL programming model and how it allows you to leverage heterogeneous compute for C++ applications based on open industry standards. You'll also get a brief introduction of oneDPL, including a glimpse of its component APIs, and it walks you through a preliminary code sample showing a practical implementation of the library. Read the article, see what your next steps are, and get the software. Thanks for watching, and let us know what you think in the comments. As always, please like and share this video, and subscribe to the Intel Software YouTube channel. I'll see you in August for the next episode of oneAPI Dev News.